This is a VAP recording for the topic of schizophrenia, done by Dr. Lim Chow Sien, psychiatric resident. This is an outline of the VAP presentation. Schizophrenia affects about 1 in 100 people. It is commonly stated as affecting males and females equally, but studies have shown it affects males slightly more. Males tend to develop schizophrenia at an earlier age than females. Peak of onset is 15 to 25 for males and 25 to 35 for females. Females have a bimodal age of onset, with a second peak occurring in middle age. Late onset schizophrenia affects more females than males. Like many other psychiatric disorders, it runs in families. First degree relatives have a tenfold increased risk of having schizophrenia. Substance misuse is more commonly found in patients with schizophrenia. The exact cause of schizophrenia is still unknown, but many theories have been developed to postulate the hypothesis. Positron emission tomography studies have demonstrated an increase in dopamine concentration and D2 receptors in patients with schizophrenia. The dopamine hypothesis of schizophrenia proposes that psychotic symptoms are caused by excessive dopamine in the brain. This is supported by the fact that antipsychotics work by antagonizing dopamine receptors in the brain. Schizophrenia has also been explained by imbalances in other neurotransmitters, notably by NMDA hypofunction. NMDA is a receptor for the neurotransmitter glutamate. Phencyclidine, an NMDA receptor antagonist, produces psychotic symptoms very similar to that in schizophrenia. Brain imaging studies have shown increased ventricular volume and other abnormalities in schizophrenia patients. Postmortem studies have shown decreased brain weight. Schizophrenia runs in families. The prevalence of schizophrenia in a child with a parent with schizophrenia is 12%. When both parents are affected, it is 40%. The concordance rate in monozygotic twins is about 45%. Current evidence suggests that schizophrenia is not caused by any single gene, but from the cumulative effect of multiple genes. There is an increased prevalence of schizophrenia in those who have experienced obstetric complications, maternal malnutrition, maternal influenza, and other viral infections. Schizophrenia is slightly more common among people born in winter, and this could be due to viral infections more common in winter. To be able to recognize and diagnose schizophrenia, an understanding of the signs and symptoms is necessary. A hallucination is a percept that is experienced in the absence of external stimulus. It is experienced as originating in external space, is perceived as being real, and cannot be terminated at will. It can occur in various modalities: auditory, visual, tactile, olfactory, and gustatory. Voices may speak out a patient's thoughts in thought echo. When voices talk to each other about the patient, it is called third-person auditory hallucination. Running commentary refers to a voice that describes exactly what the patient is doing, as if giving a commentary. These three types of auditory hallucinations are suggestive of schizophrenia. Visual hallucinations are commonly associated with organic brain disorders rather than a functional psychosis. A delusion can be defined as a belief that's untrue, unshared, unshakable, and out of a person's educational, cultural, and religious background. However, not all delusions need to be untrue. A belief can still be delusional if the mental processes used to arrive at the thought is disordered. Persecutory delusions are the most common type of delusion, and they involve beliefs of being harmed, bite, or followed. Delusions of reference are delusions that object, events, or people unconnected with the patient are in reference to him. In thought insertion, a patient believes that thoughts not belonging to him have been implanted by an external agent. Thought withdrawal is a belief that thoughts are taken out of the mind. Thought broadcast is a delusion that one's thoughts can be transmitted for others to read, as if broadcast over a radio. Delusions of control are also known as passivity phenomena. This involves beliefs that one's actions, impulse, or thoughts are controlled by an external agency. Former thought disorder refers to disturbances in the form of thought. Examples include loosening of association, derailment, and neologism. Catatonia refers to disturbance in motor behavior, which includes mannerisms, stereotypies, posturing, flexibility, echopraxia, echolalia, and negativism. To make a diagnosis of schizophrenia, the following criteria must be fulfilled. 1. Two or more of the following present for a period of 1 month. Delusions, hallucinations, disorganized speech, disorganized or catatonic behavior, and negative symptoms. 2. Significant disturbance to social occupational functioning. 3. Evidence of disturbance lasting at least 6 months. 4. Not caused by medical condition or substance use. The subtypes of schizophrenia are listed as follows. The differential diagnoses of schizophrenia include the following: delusional disorder, schizophreniform disorder, schizoaffective disorder, mood disorder, medical condition, and substance use. There is ongoing research into early intervention for those who are at risk mental state, which is a pattern of prodromal symptoms before the first psychotic episode. The disease follows a course of exacerbations and remissions. After each relapse, there is a deterioration of the patient's baseline functioning. Over time, positive symptoms decrease, but negative symptoms become more marked. Negative symptoms include affect flattening, alogia, anhedonia, apathy, and evolution. There is considerable comorbidity. Depression and substance misuse disorders are common. The risk of completed suicide is commonly quoted to be 10%. About a quarter of patients are able to lead somewhat normal lives. Another quarter continue to experience moderate symptoms, and the rest experience severe symptoms and remain functionally impaired. Schizophrenia causes major functional impairment, and the management involves looking at the biopsychosocial aspects of the illness. For pharmacological treatment, the effectiveness of antipsychotics is well established. They are classified into typical and atypical antipsychotics. Typical antipsychotics are more likely to cause extrapyridymal side effects such as Parkinsonism, akathisia, dystonia, tardive dyskinesia, oculodryad crisis, and neuroleptic malignant syndrome. Examples of typical antipsychotics are clopromazine, haloperidol, and trifluoperazine. Atypical antipsychotics cause less EPSE, but are associated with more metabolic disturbances such as weight gain, hyperlipidemia, and impaired glucose tolerance. Examples of atypical antipsychotics include risperidone, olanzapine, quetiapine, and clozapine. About a third of patients do not respond to antipsychotics. Clozapine has consistently shown superior efficacy and is indicated in treatment-resistant schizophrenia. However, it requires close monitoring of blood count levels because of the risk of agranulocytosis. Because of impaired insight, some patients may not be adherent to the prescribed treatment, and the use of intramuscular depot formulations may be considered. Studies have shown a reduced risk of relapse and better outcome for patients on depot antipsychotics. Electroconvulsive therapy is indicated in catatonic schizophrenia. Efficacy of ECT in treating acute schizophrenia is similar to, if not slightly superior, to the use of pharmacotherapy. Psychosocial approaches are used to improve insight, manage behavior, and to rehab patients.